It was 1877 when Thomas Edison was recording with his new invention, the phonograph, Mary Had a Little Lamb, and being so happy that this was the first recording ever. But a Frenchie showed up and was like, "Sorry man, I was first." This was the French inventor Édouard-Léon Scott de Martinville. He imagined a machine that would do for the ear what the camera did for the eye. His machine inscribed airborne sounds into paper, over time to be studied visually. Whom, for the sake of this video, we're just gonna call him Scott. Scott first conceived of sound recording when he was an editor and typographer of manuscripts at a scientific publishing house in Paris. One day in 1853 or 1854, he was just chilling over a text on human physiology when he envisioned an amazing possibility. He called it the imprudent idea of photographing the world. We need to work on your catchphrase, man. If photography could capture images with lenses modeled on the eye, might not a replica of the ear similarly capture spoken words? So he began building his invention, the phonograph. The phonograph used a diaphragm that responds to sound to etch the lines into paper via the soot from an oil lamp. In March 1857, Scott deposited the paperwork for a patent on a phonograph, but now laid out in great detail with drawings and a sample phonograph. In 1857, the phonograph captured the attention of SANE, an association of experts that assessed new technologies and their potential contributions to French industry. Scott spent the summer and fall improving his invention with the support of SANE and the guidance of its members. They upgraded the phonograph, which recorded only a snippet of sound, to record for 20 seconds or so. They experimented with different arrangements of the recording chain. They made experimental recordings being like, "Yo yo, mic check, 1 2, we're recording," which we can hear today using digital technologies. No, but seriously, we can hear them today, there's just some weird unrecognizable sounds. In 1859, Scott teamed up with Rudolf Koenig, a builder of precision scientific instruments. The precise measurement of time is essential to the study of sound. It was needed to accurately measure the passage of time to determine the pitch of the sound recorded on a phonograph. For this purpose, Koenig provided a tuning fork, which simultaneously tested vibrations to the sound recording strings in the soot. Actually, the oldest recognizable sound ever recorded was that of this tuning fork. In 1860, Scott made a number of recordings using this arrangement. He sang songs, he recited parts of poetry and plays in several languages. Along with his previous experiments, these are humanity's first recordings of its own voice. One of the most known recordings is that of a woman singing the French folk song Claire de la Lune, meaning the light of the moon, I think, on April 9, 1860. But collections of his work lay silent and forgotten in French institutions. The interesting thing is that the recordings was never intended to be played back, or at least the technology to play it back was never imagined at the time. Scott imagined many uses for sound recordings, but what he didn't imagine was a day when recorded voices might be heard again. Well, nor did anyone else, until, with notable synchronicity, in mid-1877, Charles Cross, who had the best hair ever, by the way, and wanted to contact the Martians by using mirrors, sketched the idea of his parlophone, and Thomas Edison began work on the phonograph. To give credit where credit is due, Edison was the first to build a working machine that would play back sound. And more importantly, like with the light bulb, he was the one who gave it popularity, so well done, Thomas. In 2008, Scott's recordings were located and played back. Scientists have managed to play back the recordings using a virtual stylus, which is really a computer program that reads the recordings from a scanned image. Honestly, the sounds are worthy for a horror movie, but hey, what do you expect? It was made in the 1860s, I mean, we're in 2017, and listen to my voiceover, it's really bad. I totally need a better mic. But anyway, I think I'll end this video with me complaining about my mic. Bye.